Hey YouTube, I'm officially on my way to San Antonio for my competition, and the first stop is going to pick up my treats for after the show at Tiff's Treats. I'm not sure if I'm going to show you guys until I eat them, because if I open it, I probably will want to eat a cookie, so we'll see. We'll test my temptations, but I'm going to go pick up the cookies and then go to San Antonio. I also have my cooler full of Icon meals and a couple things that I brought for myself. I've got like rice cakes, peanut butter, some soy sauce, water, and I have my bottle of BCAAs from First Form, the lemonade flavor. This is like almost my last few scoops. And then the back of my trunk, I have like 4 bags packed, and my husband's gonna help bring my sheets and stuff for the hotel so I don't ruin their sheets. So I didn't want to bring in like 100 bags and make like 5 trips. So I will see you guys shortly. I don't know if I'm gonna have an anxiety attack in traffic or when I compete, but I like had to get out of traffic and eat something because I have, you know, I kind of realized that I haven't eaten much. Can't even talk. I realized I haven't really eaten enough today, so I'm gonna have some rice cakes and some turkey. So I have the natural turkey from Oscar Mayer. I think there's like maybe 3 ounces of turkey left, so I'm gonna have that and 2 rice cakes. I stopped here at Buggy's to also get some gas, but this place is like super packed, traffic everywhere. I'm ready to get to San Antonio and not worry about traffic and just really relax, because I hate driving. I really don't like it. Here to borrow, you can have it in the morning. I'll get it where I'm going. I got my head high, my chest down, my eyes open wide. I got no fear, got no doubt. Pretty much all day already. I just got to the hotel, and as you can tell, I look a little wild. I got my hair curled, got my spray tan. Let me get more in the light so you can see it, but like they went really dark, which is good because my skin takes the tan really good, but also at the same time it needs to be dark. It looks a little wild right now, but it won't look that crazy later. So anyways, this is the hotel. It's actually really nice, and I like that there's a lot of room, plenty of room to get, you know, obviously spread my crap out everywhere. And I've got all of our food in the fridge. So I have all my meals. I have my meals for tomorrow spread out. Cody has some sodas. And I've got a little bit left of my BCAAs, my cookies, rice cakes, peanut butter, water, pretty much golden. I'm in the bathroom. So yeah, so far it's been fun. I like, it's just crazy how dark this all is. So when I was coming into town, I pretty much hit traffic the entire way. So a 2-hour drive turned into 3 hours. By the time I got to the hotel, I had to hurry up, check in, get myself up into the room. I haven't even had a chance to eat yet because I went to, what did I do first? It's like short-term memory loss. So first thing I did right when I got to the hotel is unpack everything, go get my polygraph done. I came back up to my room, did a quick shower, went to get my hair curled, and then got spray tanned, checked in, and I am number 90. So this is another show happening later this year that was in my bag. And then this is all the shows going on. I've got my pass, my numbers, like number 90. And then we actually got an iconic protein. I'm so excited to try this. I don't think I've tried this before, and it's chocolate truffle, so pretty cool. The macros, it's 130 calories, 2 grams of fat, 8 grams of carbs and 20 grams of protein, so not bad at all. And then I also got in some other samples. got this one, curious to try that, and a pre-workout. So cool, always like to try different things and have experiences. And then of course their t-shirts are always on point. Look at that, that's so cool. Ah, love it. I'm actually really sad because the hotel room does not have a microwave, which is like blows my mind, but I requested and asked for one, and of course right when I check in to the hotel they just gave out their last microwave. So I told them to put me on the list because I'm here for another night after tomorrow, and in order to use one I have to go downstairs and use their microwave, which I do not want to do. So I'm actually just going to eat it cold, which I hate eating cold food, but you know what, it's gonna do. I think I'm gonna try and suck it up and eat it. It's better than nothing. So going to eat. I'm a fucking warrior. I'm a warrior.
Come on, Jacqueline!
Yes, Natasha!
76! Looking good, babe.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, take a step this way.
about competition day and how I felt about it and just different things that I did differently and just kind of like break it down a little bit. So I noticed that, well, the first thing that I changed up this prep versus the last prep was I depleted water only a few days prior to the show. So for example, my first show on Monday, I was drinking a gallon of water, and then the show was on Saturday as well. So every day I cut 20 ounces of water out. So the day before show, I had about 20 ounces of water. Day of was about trace amounts of water because I'm not messing with like sodiums or anything like that. Then this show, I was drinking a gallon all week up until Thursday. I had about 50 to 60 ounces of water. Same thing with Friday. And then Saturday, I just had, you know, sips and trace amounts. So another thing to think about is I had a deep tissue massage on Thursday with my birthday. So the guy told me there that it would draw fluids up just because it's releasing toxins out of your muscles. You're releasing all kinds of things. I don't know. But he said to drink plenty of water. So I tried saving some of my water for after the massage. But he said it will make you look more full as well. So I think that that made a small difference. And then I also had my cycle. So I was off of my period on Wednesday. And so, you know, with hormones, your body's a little bit more bloated. You're holding on to water more. So I think with me drinking a whole gallon of water pretty much the entire week, I actually hurt myself by not drying out enough. And my body retained water on top of drinking a lot of water. So it kind of hurt me in a way, but I don't see it as like a bad thing. I'm actually really excited to have experienced that because now I know, you know, I can compare from my first show to my second show and know, okay, yes, I need to deplete water, especially if I'm not messing with sodiums or different things like that. And then also another thing that I did differently was carbs. So my last show, I didn't mess with any carbs the whole week. I kept everything the same. It was all consistent. And then like right before I went on stage, you know, I had some like, I think I had Snickers last time. So I just had like a couple of Snicker bites and, you know, pump weights, and that was it. This show, I had dropped my calories substantially lower. So I was about at like 125 grams of carbs versus my last show. The lowest I went was like 190 grams of carbs. So that's like a huge, that's like 60 gram difference. So on Wednesday, I increased my carbs 10 grams every day up to show day. And then I had a pretty good carb meal the evening before the show, and then also the morning of the show, because I figured I had my makeup appointment at 4:15 a.m. So I had about 45 grams of carbs. I had protein pancakes, so it's about 23 grams of protein, 40 grams or 50 grams of carbs, and then about I think it was like 4 or 6 grams of fat. I thought, okay, well, it's 4:15 a.m. I don't go on until about 12 something, so that'll be plenty of time. But I noticed that when I was looking in the mirror in the morning of show, I was like, wow, I'm not really lean. I felt kind of bloated. I felt really full. I didn't see the definition in my muscles as I did the week prior. So like right before peak week, I actually looked a lot leaner than I did show day. So it was a good experience to learn, you know, it's all a science, and you have to learn and go through it to figure out what your body needs and what you need to do for your body type. Like some people might be on higher carbs or lower carbs or whatever, same thing with water. But I noticed that I should have maybe not gone as low with carbs, continue to do more cardio than I did. Like the last 2 weeks I really struggled with doing my cardio, and I think that didn't really dry me out as much as I should have too. So it was just, I know exactly where I need to adjust, and that's what's exciting about it is I don't see it as like a bad thing, and I'm extremely excited about getting third place. It's exciting to know that I don't even have a coach. I'm figuring it all out myself, and all props to those that are doing it on their own and even having a coach. Like, it still takes so much discipline, so much work. You know, you're sacrificing so much for competition day, and it goes so fast, and I just feel blessed to be able to even place, and you know, it makes me excited. So this, and you can tell I'm getting like teary-eyed. So all the competition day feels, but I'm just really excited to get placed. I've learned a lot from my first show to this show. I know exactly what I need to do this next show around. So I think I might do a competition in June. I'm not too sure, but I'm definitely going to go do one in October. There's another show, and I think that's plenty of time to work on the areas that they told me to develop, which was my middle back and my shoulders. So I always thought my shoulders were nice, but like when I was looking at all the other girls, man, they they had some awesome shoulders. So I'm definitely going to focus on shoulders more, and definitely with range of motion. I've had some issues with my left shoulder, so it's going to be nice to really focus on range of motion, get some flexibility in there, and develop the shoulders I need to. Continue to get deep tissue massages. That's a couple things I learned. So I need to do middle back and my shoulders. Another thing is tightening up. So that was also due to water and too many carbs that, you know, fell over and made me look too full. One thing that I was really happy about is on my first competition, my feedback was to get a better suit. And then also to develop hamstrings and glutes more. So I can't remember some other feedback. I think there was like one other thing, but those were the main things that stuck out, and I knew I needed to develop that. Improvement season, I definitely focused on that. I ended up getting a better suit from Angel Competition Bikinis, and it was absolutely gorgeous. I loved it, and it was so blingy. I'm definitely going to get a little bit more jewelry too, because I love the jewelry, and it just makes you really pop on stage. And then I'll show the before and after pictures from my first competition to second, but my glute development, I was so excited about getting pictures because my development was like on point, and I'm continuing to make improvements. Some of the feedback that was positive also was I had really good symmetry and overall conditioning, but I just need to tighten up more. So I'm very happy with where I placed. I'm very happy to meet other competitors. It was really, really stiff competition, and I had no idea. Like, not gonna lie, I was kind of losing a little bit of confidence, but I knew, you know what, this is what I'm here for. I'm gonna stay confident. I need to utilize the stage properly. I was very tight, and like I got a lot more stiff than I planned on, and that was what was good about looking at a video before I went to finals, because I thought that I was doing decent, but my husband even told me, he's like, you looked very like stiff and just kind of like, I don't know, just not comfortable. And I kind of felt myself tightening up on stage, and I don't know why I was doing that, but that's the whole thing, is like competitions are great because there's always ways to improve. You might react differently than you were hoping to, and now like having another show underneath my belt lets me have the experience to know how to improve next time and be even better. So I'm gonna stop rambling. I just want to say thank you for watching. Thank you for following my journey. It's not gonna stop. I'm gonna continue making improvements. I'm just blessed to have had the experience and have a traveling show and like learn different things with my body and just have fun with it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. I'll also be doing another video coming up soon once I can catch up with editing. I had my birthday, just kind of like random stuff. And then I also have a video with a behind the scenes shoot with Eric Gomez, who's with EG Pro Photos. So stay tuned for all that. Thank you for watching. Bye. I'm a warrior.